Keiji, Tanaka.
Twenty-three-year-old Keiji Tanaka from Kuriashiki, Yokohama. Placed fourth in the four continents, pardon me, just a few weeks ago. Scored all his personal bests at that event, finishing fourth.
Three quads planned. And that's only a double, very costly. It's hard for these guys. I mean, you have to be very committed to that rotation that requires the right speed and entry and then go for it. Having another go at the same one and it's another double. So it's double trouble. Back on track with a triple axel. Keiji's using probably the more upbeat section of the music for the step sequence. And that gets the crowd going and that helps the skater too. Lifts the spirit and you're able to push on. So here is the third quad plant coming up, and he will need the speed. So at the halfway point of the program, this will be difficult. Second triple axel. Made that double toe, single loop. The star's butterfly into the flying camel. And that was a little bit dangerous. I'm not sure he's going to get all of the revs for that one. He's making some of these triples work towards the end of the program, and this is essential. That's the third one in a row. He's needed that to be able to lift the point score on the technical element side. Back entry to the camel. One final point score to add up at the top left of your screen.
23-year-old Keiji Tanaka of Japan bailed on a pair of quads off the top, fell on his third. Risk and reward.
Correct.
There you see his technical score in the upper left-hand side of your screen, well below the Canadian result.
The technical specialist will then determine whether it was a double or a triple, and, you know, according to that determination, the score will move up or move down. The judges provide the grade of execution.
He's very frustrated as he makes his way to the team bench.
Going to see this, going to see this a lot in the men. So this is the opening, I think, quad salco, which are a double, what we call pops, popped out. They just don't work, and that's just to do with timing. A step up into the axle, good rotation. I'm not convinced that he was actually able to carry off that choreography, even though his actual skills are very high. There's the selling aspect of the performance, which really needs to occur as well. Great in the air, not quite around, not quite high enough, I don't think. He wasn't able to really come down onto that landing properly. So, here's the fancy camera work into that axle. Again, I felt like he just landed it. He was able to just make the height for it. He was able to salvage a lot of points at the end of the program with the triple flip, triple toe, the triple loop, and the triple lutz. And that's necessary. It's all very well, you know, to go after the quads at the beginning, but you've got to be able to bring home the back end.
His season's best is 169.63. I don't think he's going to be very close to that.
Well, a double salco, two double salcos in a row to open are still points. They're not a mistake, but they're only, you know, 1.3 points each. So, you know, they've done 30 seconds of the program and only accrued essentially 2.6 points. So that's the deficit that's in your mind that you want to make up.
Keiji Tanaka has earned in the free program 148.36 points and is currently in fifth place.
148.36.
This brings Team Japan currently into fifth place.
So at the conclusion of the men's free skates, Canada leads 55 points. Olympic athletes from Russia have 48. Right behind